Fraud! Liar!
Imposter!
Liar! Con artist!
I've been meaning to go through my old case files for a while, but I haven't had the time. What was that noise in the yard?
Thank you.
whoever this is, I hope you've got a good reason for calling so early.
Pardon me. I'm Sherlock Holmes's grandniece, Charlotte. I wanted to speak with the chief editor of the newspaper about the recent article on my uncle.
I had a feeling you might call, and I can guess what you want to ask. Unfortunately, I can't tell you who our informant is.
From what I recall, you used to be a big fan of Mr. Holmes. So, won't you help his niece solve the mysteries of his past?
All right. I can't give you a name, but you can search the back room. There's a crowd at the main entrance, and I don't want to be involved, so you're on your own. There's a spare key to the back room in the cab. Just press the pedal.
Thank you. I'll head to the newspaper office now.
Thank you. Oh, for goodness sake. She found our hideout.
Hello, Charlotte. It's good to see you again.
So, you're behind all of this. You don't seem surprised to see me.
Quite right, my dear. You've arrived right when I thought you would.
What are you talking about? She could ruin everything!
it's a trap. But Lestrade obviously isn't in on it. Are you planning to get rid of her too?
Right again. I've rigged the building with explosives. But don't worry, Jane. The evidence won't be harmed. You can die with a sense of accomplishment.
Scoundrel! Traitor!
Who that jerk is under that mask, but I suspect he's Milverton's descendant, because he gave me the keys to this mansion. You don't need to stay with me. Just go get the original case file. That friend of yours, Watson, has it. Take the secret passage out of here. Don't bother thanking me, just go. Take this, if you don't believe me.
Charlotte, I'm so glad to see you. Come on in.
I saw what the newspaper said about Mr. Holmes, and I must admit, I expected you to visit much sooner. I haven't noticed anyone suspicious, and the original case file is securely locked away.
I'm so glad you're safe, Oscar. I was afraid I'd lose you.
This is an essential piece of evidence. I've already reported everything to the police, and they're on their way. I'll leave a message for the police in case we leave before they get here. I'm not letting you go alone, of course. This is only going to get more dangerous. Thank you.
The archives have been abandoned for a long time, so I don't think anyone would mind us looking around. Besides, it's a noble cause.
Thank you. Good morning, miss. I don't believe we've met. What can I do for you? I don't know any Milverton, and I'm not letting some stranger dig through my mother's things. If you'll excuse me, my parrot escaped, so I'm trying to find him. Thank you for saving George. You can come in for a bit, but don't overstay your welcome. gas. But these pipes should only be for ventilation. They lead to the bathroom. Can you find out what's going on here?
I have a bad feeling about this substance. I'll set up a temporary lab to examine it properly.
This is terrible. Why do they want to kill me? Because of my mother? Her things are in the attic. Here's the key.
You
I don't blame Mom for what she did. You can make her confession public. But I just ask that you explain why she did it as well. People like Milverton don't deserve a good name.
I completely agree with you. I have too much to do, so I can't stay here. But I know you can take care of yourself. My great-uncle's reputation has been restored, and Milverton's maid accepted my apology on his behalf. But one mystery remains. Who is the man in the iron mask? Someone's been in my house, and they didn't cover their tracks very well.
Hi, Charlotte. Did you receive my gift? You know, I've been thinking about you a lot these days, and perhaps if you don't mind, well, I'd like to meet and talk about us.